What's up, YouTube? Here to do my review of Miller vs. Cerrone. Let's start at the bottom. We got Ian Cicedanio versus Gerard Sanders. Fight was good. You know, Gerard wasn't a good striker. He threw a kick. Cedeno caught it and threw a counter. Dropped him, and I think when Sanders fell, he hurt his knee. And at the end of the round, he couldn't keep going, so Cedeno got the win by TKO because Sanders couldn't fight anymore. Next fight was AJ Sterling versus Hugo Vienna, and this is what I thought. I think AJ was a lot bigger. I think he wore him out, and then he eventually trapped Hugo on the spot in the third where he just couldn't move, and he just finished him with ground and pound. And then T-Bow versus Healy was also, you know, Healy, if he had fought like how he fought in the third, he probably would have won, but I mean, the first two rounds he didn't really do anything, he just let T-Bow take him down over and over again, and then in the third he finally came on, but, you know, T-Bow wasn't that tired, I mean, he barely got hit in the first two rounds, so, you know, he won that fight 29-28, in my opinion, pretty easy. He got more takedowns, did more damage those first two rounds. I mean, God, this fight card was sick. All the fights ended and finishes on the main card. The first fight was Lucas Martinez versus Alex White. In that first round, Lucas must have caught him like 7 times. He almost dropped him like 7 times. But, you know, Alex White, he got through it. And then the second round, I thought he won. I thought he was pushing forward and landing a lot of kicks and stuff. But then the third, Lucas Martinez caught him with a counter right and dropped him and knocked him out. So, you know, good win for Lucas. Next we had John Lineker versus Oskulich. And I didn't like this fight just because I thought it got stopped too early. I thought Oskulich won the first, I thought Lineker won the third, and then I thought the second. You know, I thought Lineker probably won the second, but you never know. I thought it was still a pretty close round. And then I think the second Lineker dropped Oskulich in the third, they just kind of stopped it. They didn't give Oskulich any time to defend himself, and I don't, you know, there was a couple fights like that tonight where I thought the fight got stopped a little too early. And the next fight, Joe Proctor versus Justin Salas, I thought, you know, Joe Proctor hurt Salas, he dropped him with the right, and then Salas was trying to work for a single leg, and Proctor was hitting him with hammer fist to the side of the head as Salas was working for a single leg, and the ref stopped it. And I didn't agree with that, because it's like, you gotta get that guy, he was working, he was defending himself, he was shooting for a takedown, he was just getting hit with punches, but he was never not intelligently defending himself, he was trying to defend himself, but the ref didn't give him enough time to do anything, and I didn't agree with the stoppage, but you know, Joe Proctor got the win by TKO. Next we got Rick Story versus Leonardo Mafra, and you know, it was one-sided. Rick Story just showed that he was a much better grappler. First round, he did a lot of ground and pound, took him down at will. Second round, same thing, took him down at will. And then, towards the middle of the round, he trapped Mafra in an arm triangle and choked him out. Next, we had Barboza versus Dunham. And this is what I thought. I thought Barboza would be able to, was the better striker. And, like I said, I thought it would be a body kick if he was going to finish him, and it was a body kick. So, a good win for Barboza. I think that'll probably put him at number 11 out of the top 10 lightweights. I think one more win puts him in the top 10. Cerrone versus Miller, number 6 versus number 7. You know, Cerrone, I'm glad he won. He hit Miller with that body kick, and then the ref thought it was in the balls, but it wasn't. It should have ended right there, but, you know, Cerrone still won, but he won more impressively, in my opinion, with the head kick. So now he should be ranked, like, number 3 or 4 in the world right now, I think, in my opinion. You know, he says he wants to fight Khabib, and I think that would be badass. I think the winner of Khabib and Cerrone should get the next title fight over, you know, like, especially over Ben Henderson, because he clearly didn't beat Josh. You know, Josh should be getting that title fight, not Gilbert. But whatever. You know, it happens. I'll have my review up for McGregor versus Brendel either today or tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.